All right, we're finally back with some more U2. We're checking out the song With or Without You. Let's get into it.
Smashing Pumpkins.
See the stone set in your eyes. See the thorn twist in your side. I'll wait for you. Sleight of hand and twist of fate. On a bed of nails, she makes me wait. And I wait without you, with or without you, with or without you. Through the storm we reach the shore, you give it all but I want more, and I'm waiting.
It's kind of chill.
Very chill.
Reminds me of Smashing Pumpkins. But the weird thing is, Smashing Pumpkins and U2, when I hear those names, I think they're going to be like lit, loud, like, with or without you. And they're like.
U2 sounds like a pop band or
right?
something, you know?
Right? I just did not expect it to be so chill. What do you have on this song?
Is it a girl that kind of facilitated him falling into a depression or something?
Ooh.
Because he can't live with or without her.
Oh! Okay.
You know what I mean?
Okay.
Is that your read on it?
So, I actually wasn't paying attention to the lyrics, but it had me, like, getting some, like, really complicated feelings and emotions. Like, it took me to a very complicated place. you know? And I started getting all these like thoughts about like how, like, dang, you know, if you want to, and I started like actually not paying attention to the songs, but I'm like, dang, if you want to be in a relationship, if you want to have a successful relationship, then you have to like sort of curb your personality. You have to curb yourself, and you have to like sort of work with yourself in a way that like reflects positively on the other person. But then at the same time, it's like you're going through your own like growth and maturity. And so it's really complicated. And I literally started drifting off thinking about that. And then I started paying more attention to the song. And I think that's what it's talking about. Like the complexity of like being in relationships and having to like grow as an individual and live as an individual.
I don't know. I think he was in a not very good relationship.
You think so?
Because he said, "You left me with nothing to lose and nothing to win." To me, it sounds like he's in a catch-22, kind of like a depressed scenario now.
Oh, well.
And he probably still loves her.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But they probably were not compatible.
Oh, see, I was taking it as like, you know, he more so, it's like he loves her and he has to be with her. Like, he wants to be with her, but he also wants to be himself, and there's parts of himself that
aren't. But she left him with nothing to lose and nothing to win. I mean, this is his side of the story.
Maybe he's not a winner or a loser, though. You know what I'm saying?
Sure.
Oh, that's pretty. What the heck? So that was 80s?
I don't know.
Whoa, that sounded very different. If that was 80s, I would be surprised, because that was,
I think it is 80s.
It sounded like 2000s to me.
Right, it sounds like the music they play in those big modern non-denominational churches.
Oh, it did.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And, you know, it was weird because it's like I was like, dang, this song has so many views. You know what I mean? Like, it's so popular, but like I couldn't really understand why. But I feel like it hits you. Like, it's not musically, it sounded good, but it wasn't, like, some super elaborate, you know, super complex musical thing, you know what I mean?
Right. Which, I don't care for super complex music. It's too much.
Well.
I think this is very popular because it's relatable.
Yeah, it's so relatable. It was like, I got some complex feelings, and I don't even fully understand what it was about, but I was feeling the complexity of the song, like, of the lyrics.
I don't know. Tell me, man, what do you know?
What do you know?
Me and my boys on the road. You the go. She told me, boy, you the go. Like, I don't know. But I don't know.